Okay, this is the video number 3 of the parallelogram chapter. Okay, listen to the class. The next question, continuation problem. Now the next question, what is the equation of the axis of parabola of the parabola y square plus 6y minus 2x plus 5 is equal to 0? Okay, the question is, what is the equation of the axis of the parabola? For that, first of all, we have to convert the given parabola in the formula, in the known parabola. That is, first we write this equation as y square plus 6y is equal to 2x minus 5. After that, we add the number 9 to this equation. That is, y square plus 6y plus 9 is equal to 2x minus 5 plus 9. So this value is y plus 3 whole square is equal to 2x plus 4. That is, this is y plus 3 whole square is equal to 2 into x plus 2. Okay. Now clearly this is in the form of the y minus 3 whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Now what is the axis of parabola to this equation? Y minus 3 is equal to, this is the axis of parabola. Therefore, axis of parabola of this equation is y plus 3 is equal to 0. Understand? Therefore, axis of parabola is y plus 3 is equal to 0. That's all. This is the answer. And that is the first option. Okay, listen to the next question. The axis of symmetry of the conic y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. We want the axis of the symmetry. What is the formula? We are finding the axis of symmetry is fx is equal to 0. That is, what is the equation here? Ax squared plus bx plus c minus y is equal to 0. This is the given equation. Now, what is the value of the fx doing the partial derivative with respect to x here? That is, ax square derivative 2ax plus x derivative b, c derivative 0, y derivative 0 is equal to 0. That's all. This is the answer. Axis of symmetry is nothing but the, just we have to take the fx is equal to 0. 2ax plus b is equal to 0, and that is the third option. Okay. Okay, listen to the next question. The vertex of the parabola 2y square plus 3y plus 4x minus 2 is equal to 0. We want the vertex value. So first we take the given equation here and we write this equation as 2x square plus 3y is equal to minus 4x plus 2. Understand? Just we are taking the y terms at one side. Now taking 2 common here from the left hand side, that is 2 into, that is 2 into y square plus 3y to 8y is equal to minus 4x plus 2. Okay. Now to make the perfect square at the left hand side, we add some value, and what is that value? This is nothing but 2 into 3 by 4 into 5. What is now? This is in the form of a square plus 2ab. What is b square value? 3 by 4 whole square. That is 3 by 4 whole square is equal to here minus 4x plus 2 plus. What is the value? Here we add the value 2 into 3 by 4 whole square. Now we add the same value at this place also. That is, this is equals to 2 into 3 by 4 whole square. Understand? Here we add the value 2 into 3 by 4 whole square. So we take the same value at this place also. Now this is 2 into, this is y plus 3 by 2 whole square. Y plus 3 by 4 whole square is equals to, now this is equal to minus 4x plus 2 plus, this is 2 into 9 by 16, that is 2 by 8, that is 9 by 8, okay? Now this is equals to, now here I take minus 4 common from these terms, then we get minus 4 into x minus 2 by 4 minus 9 by 32, okay? Now taking 32 LCM here, now this is minus 4 of x minus, now we take the 32 LCM to these two values, then what we get? Minus 16 minus 9. Therefore, this is equals to minus 4 of x minus 25 by 32. Okay? Therefore, this value is equals to y minus of minus 3 by 4 whole square is equal to minus 4 by 2 into x minus 3 by 32. Okay? Now, clearly, this is in the form of y minus k whole square is equal to minus 4a into x minus h. Now, what is the vertex here? K is equal to minus 3 by 4 and h is equal to 25 by 32. Therefore, the vertex h comma k is equals to, the answer is 25 by 32 comma minus 3 by 4. That's all. And this is the second option. Okay, listen to the next question. What is the focus of the parabola? We want the focus. Okay, first converting into the known parabola form, that is 4x square minus 12x is equal to minus 8 by minus 13. Okay, now here I take 4 common first, that is 4 into x square minus 3x is equal to minus 8 by minus 13. Okay. And this is 4 into x square minus this is 2ab. Converting the middle value as the 2ab form, that is 2 into 3 by 2 into x plus. What is the middle value? 3 by 2. So adding the value 3 by 2 whole square here. 3 by 2 whole square here. So this is equals to minus 8 by minus 13 plus 4 into 3 by 2 whole square. Okay, 4 into 3 by 2 whole square. Just adding the same term at this place also. Now this becomes 4 of this is a minus b whole square, that is x minus 3 by 2 whole square is equals to this is minus 8 by minus 13 plus 9. Okay, 4 into 9 by 4, that is equals to 4. So this becomes minus 8 by minus 4. Now taking minus 8 common here, then we get 5 plus 1 by 2. Understand? That is, this 4 into 4 of x minus 3 by 2 whole square is equal to this value. Now here 4 is cancelled by 2 times, therefore the equation becomes x minus 3 by 2 whole square is equals to minus 2 of 5 minus minus 1 by 2. Now clearly this is in the form of x minus h whole square is equal to minus 4 a into 5 minus k. Now what is h comma k here? H is equal to 3 by 2 and k is equal to minus 1 by 2 and 4a is equal to 2 means a is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, these are the values. Now clearly this is in this form. Now what is the given question? What is the focus of the parabola? What is the focus formula to this form? To this one, what is the answer? Focus is equal to h comma k minus a. Okay, to this form, to this parabola, the focus is equal to h comma k minus a. Now substituting the values. Now this is 3 by 2 comma. What is k value? Minus 1 by 2. And what is a value? Minus 1 by 2. Therefore the answer is 3 by 2 comma minus 1. Just to simply converting the given equation into the known formula, in the form of the formula, and after that we have to take the focus to that equation. That's okay. The next question. What is the equation of directrix of the parabola? We want the equation of the directrix. Okay. So first to take the simplification of the given equation, that is converting the given equation into the known formula, that is the first step is y square plus 4y is equal to 5x minus 9. Okay, that is what is the next step? Adding the number 4 to this equation on both sides. That is, y square plus 4y plus 4 is equal to 5x minus 9 plus 4. Now what is this? This is 5 plus 2 whole square is equal to this is 5x minus 5. Now taking 5 common here, then we get 5 into x minus 1. That is, y minus minus 2 whole square is equals to 5 into x minus 1. Now clearly this is in the form of the y minus k whole square is equal to 4a of x minus h. Okay. Now the given parabola is in the form of the y minus k whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Now what is the equation of the directrix to this equation? What is the equation of the directrix formula? Equation of directrix is x minus h plus a is equal to 0. Understand? So this is the formula of the equation of the directrix to this equation. That is x minus, what is h value? H is equals to 1. And what is a value here? What we have? 4a is equal to 5. That is, what is a value? A is equal to 5 by 4. That is, this value is equal to 5 by 4 here. After taking the LCM, then what we get? 4x plus 1 is equal to 0. That's all. And this is the second option. Okay, listen to the next question. The ends of the lattice rectum of a parabola are 6, 7, 6, minus 1. Then what is its vertex? So here ends of the lattice rectum are given. We want the vertex of the parabola. Okay, listen. So here what are the given points? 6, 7, 6, minus 1. That is, what is the equation of the line passing through these two points? X is equal to 6. X is equal to 6 means that is the line parallel to the y axis. Okay. Now these are the end points. What are the end points here? First point is equal to 6, 7 and second point is equal to 6, minus 1. This is the lattice rectum. What is the meaning of the lattice rectum? That is the line that passes through the focus and perpendicular to the axis of the parabola. Okay. Suppose this is the vertex, then what is the equation of the parabola? This is the equation of the parabola. If suppose this is the vertex, then what is the equation of the parabola? Then what is the shape of the parabola? If suppose this is the vertex, then what is the shape of the parabola? This is the shape of the parabola. If suppose this is the vertex, then what is the shape of the parabola? This is the shape of the parabola. Understand? Now what is this point? This point is nothing but the midpoint of the endpoints. What is focus here? Focus is nothing but the midpoint of the endpoints of the lattice rectum. So what are the coordinates here? 6 plus 6, by 2. That is 12 by 2 is equal to 6 and 7 minus 1 by 2. That is 6 by 2 is equal to 3. Here focus is equal to 6 comma 3. Okay. And what is the length of the lattice rectum here? Length of the lattice rectum is equal to 7 plus 1. That is 8. That is 4a is equal to 8. Then the value of a is equal to 2. Understand? A is equal to 2 means this distance is equal to 2. What is the distance between the focus and vertex? That value is always equals to A here. That is, this value is equal to 2. Similarly, this value is equal to 2. Now, what are the corners of the vertices here? Now, what is the vertex here? So, this point is equal to 6, 3. This distance is equal to 2. Then here, the vertex is equal to 8, 3. Understand? 6 plus 2, that is equal to 8, 3. And here 6 minus 2, that is equal to 4 by 3 along the x axis. Along the x axis, only the x coordinates are changed. Y coordinates are not changed. That is 6 plus 2, that equals to 8. And here 6 minus 2, that is equals to 4. Now, what are the possible values for the vertex here, for the vertices? Either 4, 3 or 8, 3. But in the options, 4, 3 is not given. So, it is only given. So, this is the correct answer. And this is the first option. Of course, here the possibilities are these two points. But in the options, only this point is given. So, this is the correct answer. And this is the first option. That's all. Okay, listen to the next question. AB is the focal point of the parabola y square is equal to 4a. And if e is equal to 4a comma 4a, then what are the coordinates of the B point? Okay, what is given here? To the parabola y square is equal to 4ax, AB is the focal curve. Okay, this is the focal curve of the parabola. What is the meaning of the focal curve? That is the line that passes through the focus. That is, this is the line passing through the point A comma 0. And also given that the coordinates of the point A is equal to 4a comma 4a, then what are the coordinates of the B point? Now we want this point. Understand? Already we have one formula that is related to the focal cord. What is that one? If one end of the focal cord is equal to 80 square comma 280, then the other end of the focal cord is a by t square comma minus 2 a by t. Okay. If one end is equal to 80 square comma 280, then what is the other end coordinates? A by t square comma minus 2 a by t. This is the formula. Understand? So apply that formula. Okay, see here, 80 square is equal to 4a. 80 square is equal to 4a means t square is equal to 4, and the value of t is equal to 2. Understand? T is equal to 2. Now substituting t is equal to 2 here, then what we get? A by 4 comma minus 2a by 2. That is equals to, so this is equals to a by 4 comma minus a. That's all. This is the answer. Just to simply applying the formula, in a focal curve, one end is equal to 80 square comma 280, then the second end will be a by t square comma minus 2 a by t. Just to simply applying that formula to get the coordinates of the second one. That's all. This is the answer, and that is the second option. Okay, listen to the next question. Equation of the focal cord of the parabola y square is equal to 4x, which is inclined at an angle pi by 4 with the x axis. Okay, listen. One parabola is given. This is the given parabola. Y square is equal to 4x. And this is the x axis. This is the vertex. This is the focus. Okay. Now, what is given? The focal cord. The focal cord of the parabola y square is equal to 4x makes an angle pi by 4 with the x axis. Okay. This is the given data. So, the line makes an angle pi by 4 with the x axis. Then, what is the slope of this line? Slope of the line is equal to tan theta. Tan theta is equal to tan pi by 4. That is equals to 1. Okay. And what is the line? This is the focal cut. Means this is the line that passes through the focus. What is the focus of this parabola? Here 4a is equal to 4 means a is equal to 1. Now, what are the focus coordinates? A comma 0. But a is equal to 1. That is 1 comma 0. Now, what is the given question? We want the equation of this line. What is the formula? Already here we know the point on the line and slope value. Now, what is the formula? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Therefore, the answer is x minus y minus 1 equal to 0. And that is the last option. Okay. Now, the next question. The equation y is equal to root x represents. So, after squaring on both sides, what we get? Y square is equal to x. Y square is equal to x means this is the equation of the parabola. But y is equal to root x means it represents a semi-parabola. Okay, this is not the parabola. it represents the only semi-parabola. So answer is the second option. Okay, y square is equal to x plus, this is the equation of the parabola. Y is equal to root x plus, this is not the complete parabola, this is only the semi-parabola. Understand? Now the next question, sum number 26. Find the equation of the parabola whose focus is equal to 1 comma 2 and equation of the directrix is x plus 1 is equal to 0. So here focus is given and equation of the directrix is given. What is the equation of the parabola? Just simply applying the formula SP by PM is equal to 1 here to get the equation of the parabola. Understand? What is P here? P means we take that is equals to x1, y1 or x comma 1, whatever the point. Okay, now replacing the values here. SP is equal to PM. What is SP value? Square root of x1 minus 1 whole square plus y1 minus 2 whole square is equals to PM value under modulus of x1 plus 1 by root 1 square. Now squaring on both sides, then what we get? Y1 minus 2 whole square is equal to x1 plus 1 whole square minus x1 minus 1 whole square. Okay. After taking the simplification, then what we get? Y1 square plus 4 minus 4y1 is equal to, this is a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square. What is that value? 4ab, that is 4x1. Therefore, the answer is 5c minus 4x minus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. That's all. And that is the first option. Okay, listen to the next question. Find the equation of the parabola whose vertex is 2 comma minus 3 and whose axis is parallel to x axis and length of the lattice rectangle is equal to 8. Okay, here length of the lattice rectangle is equal to 8 means given that 4a is equal to 8. Okay, vertex is equal to 2 comma minus 3 means h comma k is equal to 2 comma minus 3. And also given that axis is parallel to x-axis, then what is the equation of the parabola formula? Y minus k whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Understand? So since the axis is parallel to x-axis, we have to take the formula as y minus k whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Now substitute the values. 5 plus 3 whole square is equal to 8 into x minus 2. That's all. This is the answer. And which is the third option? Okay. Question, find the equation of the parabola whose focus is equal to 3 comma 2 and vertex is equal to minus 1 comma 2. So what is given here? What is given here? Focus is equal to 3 comma 2, s is equal to 3 comma 2 and vertex is equal to minus 1 comma 2. That is a is equal to minus 1 comma 2. Now what is the equation of the parabola? Okay. Now what is the line which passes through these two points? Y coordinates are equal. That is y is equal to 2 is the axis of the parabola. Understand? Y is equal to 2 is the axis of the parabola. So first we plot the points here. So this is x axis, this is y axis. What is 3 comma 2? So this is the point 3 comma 2. Okay. This is 3 comma 2. And what is minus 1 comma 2? So this is the point minus 1 comma 2. Understand? X is equal to minus 3, y is equal to 2. So what is the parabola shape here? So this is the shape of the parabola. So this is the shape of the parabola means what is the equation? Y minus k whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Understand? So this is the shape of the parabola. Just to plot the focus and vertex point, then what we get? This is the shape of the parabola. That is the answer is y minus k whole square is equal to 4a into x minus h. Now what is a value? Just simply the distance between these two points. What is the distance value here? 3 minus of minus 1, that is equals to 4. Therefore the answer is y minus k whole square means y minus 2 whole square is equal to 16 into x minus of minus 1, x plus 1. That's all. This is the answer and that is the third option. Okay, listen, this is the last question of the parabola. What is the question here? If the chord joining the points T1, T2 subtends a right angle at the vertex of the parabola y square is equal to 4ax, then what is T2 value? Okay, listen. So this is the given parabola y square is equal to 4ax. And this is the chord which passes through the points T1, T2. That is, what is T1 here? T1 is equal to at1 square, comma 2at1. And T2 is equal to AT2 square comma 2AT2. Understand? So this is the chord T1, T2. These are the points. Now the chord subtends a right angle at the origin. Okay? This is the origin, vertex of the parabola. Now the chord subtends a right angle at the vertex of the parabola. Then what is T2 value? Okay? Given that this angle is equal to 90 degrees. Angle is equal to 90 degrees means these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Perpendicular means m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. Now what is m1 value? M1 is equal to slope of this line, that is 2a t2 by at1 square, and this is equal to 2 by t1. Similarly, what is m2 value? It is equal to 2 by t2. Okay, now what is the given condition? The lines are perpendicular. The lines are perpendicular means m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1, that is 2 by t1 into 2 by t2 is equal to minus 1, that is 4 by t1 t2 is equal to minus 1. That is 4 by t1 t2 is equal to minus 1. But what we want? We want the value of the t2. From this equation, what is t2? t2 is equal to minus 4 by t1. That's all. This is the answer, and that is the first option. Okay.